calm before the storm. Things aren't as they were before. Your best start price. Did you think you could keep us all? Welcome to MedScience. What is the diagnosis of this picture? Option 1 is basal cell carcinoma. Option 2 is Hallo-Nevus. Option 3 is Lichen planus. Option 4 is malignant melanoma. Option 5 is Splitz nevus. So what is the answer is, this picture is Hallo-Nevus. Okay, why is the Hallo-Nevus? You can see the irregular pattern of the outside, also inside the nevus presented with hyperpigmentation, but you can see the border of depigmentation, also hypertrichosis. We can see the whitish border over there. Also the marked will be irregularly. Okay, the halo nevi, the benign nevi that develop the border of depigmentation resembling by the halo, and it is the border of variegated color and hypertrichosis and small scattered macules, and is the irregularly scoped by the border of the typical and congenital melanocytic nevus. The halo nevus, you can see the patient with associated with vitiligo and spontaneous regression of with this myelocytic lesions. Move on to next pictures. This is the picture of gum infiltration of the patient of AML, acute myelogenous leukemia patient. The answer would be the leukemia. Okay, answer is leukemia. The patient presented with fatigue, fever, anorexia and weight loss. What is the most likely diagnosis? Leukemia. You can see the gum infiltration. There is a hyperplasia present with that condition of with acute myelogenous leukemia. Okay, this is the gingival infiltration resolved after the treatment of acute myelocytic leukemia. Okay, move on to next. This is the blood smear showing the child developed with high fever after returning from the camping trip from the California. What is the diagnosis is? Option 1 is rabosius. Option 2 is brucellosis. Option 3 is leptospirosis. Option 4 is Rocky Mountain spotted fever. Option 5 is tick-borne relapsing fever. So what is the probable answer in this blood, peripheral blood smear shown that tick-borne relapsing fever? This is the picture of the Borrelia chemischi. The Borrelia chemischi spirochete visible on the blood smear. There is a rodent associated with the Borrelia chemischi, a common cause of tick-borne relapsing fever from the North America, and it is transmitted by the night biting and soft tick also. Okay, what is the treatment of this patient is doxycycline. Okay, what is the diagnosis of this picture? This is the picture of tophaceous gout. Yeah, easily we can answer this question, this kind of questions. Tophaceous gout. We cannot see the gonococcal arthritis, herpes nodules, rheumatoid arthritis, sarcoidosis. There are will be different features will be present with that also. We can rheumatoid arthritis, there is a multiple present with that joints, but in the tophaceous gout there is a infiltration of the white crystals present the uriate. We can diagnose this condition in polarized microscopy. We can diagnose that tophaceous gout. Move on to next. This patient present with a picture of this leg, the livedo reticularity is present with. What would be expected finding this renal biopsy is, cholesterol crystals. Why is the cholesterol crystals? Patient presented with the renal failure 5 weeks after the coronary artery bypass grafting with done. The case of coronary artery bypass grafting done with Athermometus plaqueus will be disrupted in the arterial manifestation. Okay, we can see the progressive subacute renal dysfunction. Also, we can see the livedo reticularis, also digital cyanosis. The patient examination showed the pericutaneous kidney biopsy revealed the obstructive cholesterol crystals. Also, that within the arcuate artery confirmed the diagnosis of the cholesterol embolus syndrome. She ultimately died of the species. This is the picture of the patient with rickets. Which of the one of the following is biochemical measure with highly elevated in this condition of the rickets patient? There is a presented with wine spot deformity. This is the genome varum. So what is the probable elevated in this patient condition is alkaline phosphate. Other than all the calcium, ferritin, phosphorus 25, all vitamin D all and will be reducible. Because the patient present with genu varum, wine spot deformity and nutritional rickets, there is a usually we can see the alkaline phosphate can be increased. Okay. Note the point, the ferritin is not usually elevated in these patients. What is the diagnosis of this picture? Cutaneous leishmanias, cutaneous larva migrans. The third is epidermoid cyst, fourth is funicular meiosis and trichorhinous. The answer is funicular meiosis. Why is a funicular meiosis? This is the picture of outside from the skin present with the human fat flea larva that is called Dermatopia hominis emerging from the inflamed nodule. The patient with upper arm. So, other than all cutaneous leishmanias, larva migrans, there are other feature. Upcoming videos, I will tell that. Okay. This is the phone scan of the patient with presented with cough. What is the diagnosis combination finding this bone scan? Okay. We can see this patient condition of the bone scan. In this patient with the tibial bone, also that in the radial bone also, we can there is a metastatic can be happen in lung cancer due to there is a stage 4B can be developed in the femoral also. Okay. We can see the tibial and ulna and femoral, we can see the metastatic lung cancer. Okay, it can be uptake of a consisting of the metastatic to the diffuse linear uptake to the femoral and tibial bone. What is the answer in? This is the hypertrophic pulmonary osteoarthropathy may be present with that this kind of patient, the lung cancers and gastric cancers. Okay, move on to next. This is the picture of the hand. Patient has the dermatitis of the from the sunburn, like okay. This is the photosensitive dermatitis presented with this patient. The deficiency of following that of biotin, folate, niacin, riboflavin, vitamin C. So what would be the answer is niacin. Why is the niacin is most commonly the photosensitivity dermatitis is niacin only. Okay, the sunburn like the hyperpigmented rash, also the clearly demarcated border of the midway arm of the photosensitivity distribution present. Also we can see the Bellagra niacin deficiency. Okay, this is the Bellagra niacin deficiency, there is a rash. Other component of the patient with biotin, folate, riboflavin, there is a other features will be presented with this patient. Okay, this is the what is the diagnosis of this patient is, this is the easy questions. This is a cutaneous larva migrans. Okay, we can see the cutaneous larva migrans easily identify. There is a bulla formation presented with the visible in the larva looking the blood vessel. Okay, The serponaceous erythematous raised in the tract with the pulla formation. The clinically diagnosed with the cutaneous larva migrans. There is a cookworm present. The most commonly associated with the cookworm infected by the dogs and cats. That is, what is the organism presented with this condition is Anglostoma brasinelli. Move on to next picture. This is the patient presented with a high speed motor vehicle crash. What is the structure can be disrupted. Okay, you can see the x-ray carefully. We can see the aorta. We can see the diaphragm will be different level. Okay, we can see the esophagus. We can see the myocardium, also trachea. Okay, so what could be the answer is diaphragm. Why? Because the right diaphragm can be elevated on the right side. Okay, so we can change that this one is diaphragm. Okay, the hemidiaphragm suggests the traumatic rupture. Okay, we can see the CT scan of this patient confirming to the diagnosis of the diaphragmatic rupture. Also, the dome of the liver had herniated into the right hemithorax. Okay, this is the diagnosis of the hemothorax on side. Okay, thank you so much.